Kicking the Leaves. This is a poem I wrote in Michigan just before Jane and I moved to the house in New Hampshire. And I knew we were going to come and camp out at any rate. And the poem really seems to know that I'm going to be moving in here and living here. It's a kind of farewell to the old life, looking forward to the new. Kicking the Leaves, October, as we walk home together from the game in Ann Arbor, on a day the color of soot, rain in the air. I kick at the leaves of maples, reds of 70 different shades, yellows like old paper, and poplar leaves, fragile and pale, and elm leaves, flags of a doomed race. I kick at the leaves, making a sound I remember, as the leaves swirl upward from my boot and flutter. And I remember October's walking to school in Connecticut, wearing corduroy trousers that swished with a sound like leaves, and a Sunday buying a cup of cider at a roadside stand on a dirt road in New Hampshire, and kicking the leaves, autumn 1955 in Massachusetts, knowing my father would die when the leaves were gone. Each fall in New Hampshire, on the farm where my mother grew up, a girl in the country, my grandfather and grandmother finished the autumn work, taking the last vegetables in from the cold fields, canning, storing roots and apples in the cellar under the kitchen. Then my grandfather raked leaves against the house as the final chore of autumn. One November, I drove up from college to see them. We pulled big rakes, as we did when we hayed in summer, pulling the leaves against the granite foundations, around the house, on every side of the house. And then, to keep them in place, we cut spruce boughs and laid them across the leaves, green on red, until the house was tucked up, ready for snow that would freeze the leaves in tight like a stiff skirt. Then we puffed through the shed door, taking off boots and overcoats, slapping our hands, and sat in the kitchen, rocking, and drank black coffee my grandmother made, three of us sitting together, silent, in gray November. One Saturday, when I was little, before the war, my father came home at noon from his half day at the office and wore his bait sweater, black on red, with the crossed hockey sticks on it, and raked beside me in the backyard, and tumbled in the leaves with me, laughing, and carried me, laughing, my hair full of leaves, to the kitchen window, where my mother could see us and smile and motion to set me down, afraid I would fall and be hurt. Kicking the leaves today, as we walk home together from the game, among crowds of people with their bright pennants, as many and bright as leaves. My daughter's hair is the red-yellow color of birch leaves, and she is tall like a birch, growing up 15, growing older. And my son, flamboyant as maple, 20, visits from college and walks ahead of us, his step springing, impatient to travel the woods of the earth. Now I watch them from a pile of leaves beside this clapboard house in Ann Arbor, across from the school where they learn to read, as their shapes grow small with distance, waving. And I know that I diminish, not them, as I go first into the leaves, taking the way they will follow, Octobers and years from now. This year the poems came back when the leaves fell. Kicking the leaves, I heard the leaves tell stories, remembering and therefore looking ahead and building the house of dying. I looked up into the maples and found them, the vowels of bright desire. I thought they had gone forever. While the bird sang, I love you, and shook its black head from side to side, and its red eye with no lid, through years of winter, cold as the taste of chicken wire, the music of cinder block. Kicking the leaves, I uncover the lids of graves. My grandfather died at 77 in March when the sap was running. And I remember my father, 20 years ago, coughing himself to death at 52 in the house in the suburbs. Oh, how he flung leaves in the air, how they tumbled and fluttered around us like slowly cascading water when we walked together in Hamden before the war, when Johnson's Pond had not surrendered to houses, the two of us hand in hand, and in the wet air the smell of leaves burning. And in 6 years, I will be 52. Now I fall, now I leap and fall, to feel the leaves crush under my body, to feel my body buoyant in the ocean of leaves, the night of them, night heaving with death and leaves rocking like the ocean. Oh, this delicious falling into the arms of leaves, into the soft laps of leaves. Face down, I swim into the leaves, feathery, breathing the acrid odor of maple, swooping in long glides to the bottom of October, where the farm lies curled against winter, and soup steams the breath of onion and carrot onto damp curtains and windows. And past the windows, I see the tall bare maple trunks and branches, the oak with its few brown feathery remnant leaves, and the spruce trees holding their green. Now I leap and fall, exultant, recovering from death, on account of death, in accord with the dead, the smell and taste of leaves again, and the pleasure, the only long pleasure, of taking a place in the story of leaves.